hit strings off. We hit strings by mistake.
Good morning.
Good morning,
and welcome to our worship service on this wonderful weekend. We have a wonderful celebration today of Children's Sunday, Confirmation Sunday, Bible Sunday, Stewardship Sunday, Graduate Sunday, all kinds of wonderful things we're celebrating on this good day that has been made by our loving Creator. We gather together to rejoice. We have a few announcements this morning. Would like to offer a word of thanks to those who are assisting me in leading our worship service today. For Claire Cheka, Evian Owen Sheehan Pond, thank you. For Will Wiersbowski, TJ Corwin, Caleb Sawicki, Kevin O'Neill, Donna Wall, and Heidi Bilbo. As well, thanks to our musicians today. Joe Haddad, Jan Berry, and Joyce Simpson for our all-star tech crew, Christine McGarry and Rob Bardell. And also for our deacons and our music board for assisting us in setting up this service today. We have a note from our deacons that refreshments will be available following the service. And if you are in need of water at any point during the service, you can find some water over by the door leading down to the food pantry. So help yourself. Confirmants, please stick around after our service today. We're going to take some photos, so don't run off right away. We know you want to go party with your families after our big moment together, but please stick around for just a little bit before you do. Our children's program will be resuming right here in our building next week. So we will be gathering to worship in our sanctuary. And after our kids are dismissed, following the children's message, we will have a program for them either outside or in Fellowship Hall. And we'll be running this program throughout the summer. We'd like to call attention to our graduates. We have many young people and a little bit less than young people who are graduating or have graduated from schools of various kinds. You can see their names and accomplishments listed on the back pages of your bulletin. So please take a look at that in the service, but not during the sermon, of course. And you can see all the wonderful things that the people of our congregation have accomplished and where they're going next. And I think that's about it. So now I would just like to welcome you all to worship. I welcome you if you're a new visitor or an old friend. If you are in search of a new home for your church, if you need strength, if you want to follow Christ, we welcome you if you have doubts or you do not believe. We welcome those of you who are grandparents, who are mothers, fathers, and single people. We welcome the people of all colors, cultures, abilities, of all sexual orientations, gender identities, and gender expression. We welcome the old and we welcome the young. We welcome you if you are a believer or a questioner. And we welcome you or if you are a questioning believer. Welcome to everyone. No matter who you are, where you are on life's journey, or whom you love, you are welcome here. We hope that you find in this time of worship peace and uplift for your spirit. And now let us begin our time of worship with our call to worship.
It is good to give thanks to God. Come to make music to our Creator.
God knows our troubles and remembers our needs. Our cries for help are answered and our heart's desire is fulfilled.
Declares God's steadfast love and faithfulness. Seek God's help when you gather worship.
We know that God will help the anointed ones. Our pride is in God alone.
Listen for the voice of God speaking to us again. How great is our God, O rock and defender.
God will respond when we call. We will bear fruit for God as long as life endures.
And as our youngsters are seated, please join me in offering our unison prayer of invocation as it is printed in your bulletin. Let us unite our voices. We turn to you, God of all worlds, knowing we can depend on you when earthly rulers stumble and fall, when other relationships are strained and broken, when we are faced with difficult challenges. It is good to sing your praises, even when we do not feel like singing. It is good to declare your faithfulness when we have been unfaithful. It is good to give thanks, for when we do, we are reminded of the multitude of blessings we so often take for granted. Lead us in this time of worship. Amen. And as we are gathered outside together, we are going to sing aloud. So let us lift our voices in song together for our first hymn, Come, O Thankful People, Come. And if your chair is not slung too low and you are able, you may rise and stand and sing with us.
Come, O Thankful People, come.
Beautiful. Please be seated. I invite Will Wierzbowski to come forward to lead us in our call to confession and unison prayer of confession.
Each of us are called by God to give our best and bear the fruit of God's realm. We who gather here are called to be faithful family, in which all bow humbly before God, moved by the love of Christ. This is a time to look at ourselves before our Creator.
Let's pray together.
God of all truth, who can stand before you? We judge by how things look on the outside, but you look at our hearts. You see what is on the surface, but you find beauty deep within. We measure importance by what we earn, but you find value among those who deem lowly and without worth. You offer us the deep and amazing joy of living in your realm. We forget your promises and turn to things that separate us from you and hurt friendships with one another. We seek forgiveness and a new direction for our lives. Amen.
All of us must stand before the judgment seat of Christ today and every day. Hear the good news. When we come seeking forgiveness, we can win a victory over sin. Christ died for us that we might no longer live only for ourselves. In Christ, we no longer regard others from a human point of view. We are a new creation. The old has passed away, the new has come. We can live with confidence urged on by the love of Christ to joyous and daring service. And now I invite Heidi Bilbo to come forward to lead us in our children's message.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Who can name something tiny for me? Let's holler out some tiny things that we can think of.
Fleas.
There you go. That's a good one. What else?
Ants.
Very good one. Do we have others? Did I hear you, Trent? What did you say? Bugs?
All bugs.
Lots of bugs. We got a bug theme going here. What, Claire?
Pebbles.
There you go. Good job, guys, thinking of some tiny things. You know, I don't normally think about tiny things like that. I guess because when things are tiny, we don't really notice them. I mean, think about it. If a horse came walking through church right now, do you think we would notice them? Yeah, I think we'd all notice them, huh? Now, if an ant came crawling through church right now, do you think we'd notice that? No, we may or may not notice that. And even though it's much smaller than a horse, we still want to remember that those ants are alive and they have very important jobs. The Bible today tells us about another kind of tiny thing. For the kids that I've already handed them out, your mom or your dad or your grown-up will give you a little bottle that we're going to talk about. If you didn't get one, come and see me after service and we'll make sure all the kids get one. Can anybody tell me what kind of seed is in the bottle that I handed out? What do we have? Will. A mustard seed. That's right. We all have a bottle with little mustard seeds. They're pretty tiny, aren't they? They're really small. But mustard seeds don't stay small. Once you plant them, they grow up to be huge. They can be bigger than Nathan. They can be bigger than Jillian. They can be bigger than me. They can be bigger than a building. Mustard seeds grow huge. So look at your plants, look at your seeds, because the next part is what I think is the really cool part. Jesus says in the story today that you only need faith the size of this tiny little mustard seed. And with this tiny little mustard seed, you can do great things. We plant that mustard seed, we take care of it. It grows up into a massive tree, and that tree has flowers that then releases more seeds, and those seeds grow more mustard trees and more mustard for all of us to enjoy. And what Jesus wants us to learn from this story is that we have little mustard seeds within us. For those of you that have in the past come to Sunday school or continue to come to Sunday school, you come because you are small and you know a little bit about Jesus. But the more stories we share, the more you grow and the more your faith grows. And then you can go out and you can tell your friends the stories that you learned. And then they can grow in Jesus's word too. And before you know it, our Sunday school turns from a few kids that are gathering on Sunday to hopefully the size of a whole building that we can enjoy that faith together and continue to grow in Jesus's word. So what I want you all to do is to keep your bottles of mustard seed close by you when you go home today. And sometimes in the morning or sometimes when you go to bed, I want you to think about that mustard seed and think what you can do to help spread Jesus's faith in the world.
Thank you, Heidi. And we are going to be shortly presenting Bibles to our third graders, which is a wonderful thing to do because we believe that God's message comes to us in the Bible. And God's message, when we read it, can get inside of us. Just like if you eat a leafy plant, you take that plant inside of you and it gives you energy. You can have a leafy plant of God's message growing in you and giving you energy. I'm looking at this raised garden bed that was put in not too long ago by Gina Wiersbowski and her troop of Girl Scouts. And Gina, where are you? All right, Gina's hanging out over here. Good job, Gina. Thank you. And I can see that your lovely little plants are only about yay big. Are they gonna stay yay big? No, they're gonna grow real big. And we've got some trellises, you've got some beans over there, there's some zucchinis, and those zucchinis are tiny now, but they're gonna get really big by the fall. You know, sometimes when you plant things, they grow and they can become so much larger. And God's message is like that. When it's inside of us, it can grow and become larger. And so that's why we care so much about giving you a Bible so that you can read it and understand God's message and it can grow inside of you and become something much greater than it is even now. So when you receive your Bibles, cherish them because they can grow to be something even more beautiful when you read them and understand the words in them. Now with that, we are going to be presenting our third graders' Bibles, and I invite Heidi to lead us once again in this moment.
So for those of you that are getting Bibles today, I just want to explain the extra little piece that comes with your Bible. Each child will receive a bag that has a few essential items that they will need as they carry their Bible with them. One is a bookmark. So as you read the stories in your Bible, you'll have a lovely bookmark to keep your place, so you'll remember where you left off after reading your last story. The other two items that come with it are a highlighter and a set of little post-it note flags. We often sometimes think that these Bibles are kind of hands-off, right? We have to read them and kind of put them aside and take care of them. That's not what I want you to do with these. This is yours. Your Bible's going to speak to you. As you read stories that you enjoy or that make you sad, I want you to highlight them, and I want you to put pages in them and flags in them so that you can come back to those stories. It's a story that makes you feel good on those days you are sad, you can come and read them. On days that you want to think about things that you can do to help others in the world, maybe you'll come back to some of those sad stories to help remind you that you can go and help others feel good. So with that, I'm going to first... Can I call them up or do I bring them? Awesome. I'm going to call up Claire Checka. Come and get your Bible. And next, we have Owen Sheehan Pond. Come on up and get your Bible, Owen. We have a few other Bible recipients that unfortunately aren't here today, but we'll acknowledge Ava Thomas and Brendan Tripp and hopefully get those Bibles to them as well.
And Will, who led us in our prayer earlier, is also receiving his Bible, even though he's not in third grade. He's already got it. But last year, we didn't gather for the special celebration, so we weren't able to recognize Will last year. So we are today. All right, so let us continue in our worship service now with our reading from Scripture. Our first reading comes to us from the book of Ezekiel, and it will be led by Madeline Macknick.
Thus says the Lord God, I myself will take a sprig from the lofty top of cedar. I will set it out. I will break off a tender one from the topmost of its young twigs. I myself will plant it on a high lofty mountain, on the mountain height of Israel. I will plant it, in order that it may produce boughs of bear fruit and become a noble cedar. Under it every kind of bird will live. In shade of its branches will nest winged creatures of every kind. All trees of the field shall know what I am the Lord. I bring low the high tree. I make the low tree. I dry up the green tree and make it the dry tree flourish. I, the Lord, have spoken. I will accomplish it.
And our gospel reading today is going to be led by Jillian Macknick. This is Mark chapter 4.
Jesus also said the kingdom of God as if someone would scatter the seed on the ground and would sleep and rise night and day, and the seed would sprout and grow. He does not know how. The earth produces on itself, first the stalk, then the head, then the full grain in the head. But when the grain is ripe, at once he goes in with his sickle, because the harvest has come. He also said, with what can we compare the kingdom of God, or what parable will we use for it? It is like a mustard seed, which will, when sown upon the ground, is the smallest of all the seeds on earth. Yet when it is sown, it grows up and becomes the greatest of all shrubs and puts forth large branches so that the birds on the air can make nests in its shade. With many such parables, he spoke the word to them as they were able to hear it. He did not speak to them except in parables, but he explained everything to his disciples. These words are breathed into us by the Holy Spirit. Thanks be to God.
It might be close enough.
I fall on my knees.
So here we are on this beautiful day, gathering under trees. We have these glorious magnolia trees and this amazing maple tree, which I think is some kind of crimson Norway maple, something. I have a little tiny version of it here. This was growing in the bushes behind where Caleb is sitting. And it's a little bit smaller than this one right here. And I also found growing in the bushes an oak. This is a mighty oak tree, or it will be, or it would have been, if I let it grow, but not anymore. Sorry, little guy. Yeah, it's amazing how glorious these trees grow just from being little seeds and sprouting and being little sprigs. They can grow to be these fantastic, grand trees. We know that these magnolias were planted in 1974. Which is a long, long time ago. But not that long ago, right, Christine? She was born in 1974 as well, so we know it wasn't that long ago. But these were planted in memory of Karen Nelson's mother, and they're beautiful trees, and look how they've grown over the years. They surely didn't look like that in 1974, did they? They were probably little things, and now they're big, not that small. But now they're big, beautiful things. Well, in today's stories, we're learning about things that were plants that started small and grew up to be big. In our reading from the Hebrew Bible, the story from Ezekiel, we read of how God takes a sprig from a cedar tree and will plant it in Israel. This was written at a time where the people of Israel were taken into the land of Babylon, and were no longer living in their homeland, and doubted that they would ever continue to exist as a people at all. But God told them that indeed they would. Though it feels like they're small and insignificant, God would take their little sprig and plant it in Israel and grow it into a mighty tree, a mighty cedar tree. And the cedar trees that grow in Israel, the cedars of Lebanon, some of them can grow 120 feet tall and 8 feet wide. That's a pretty big tree, isn't it? So it's a beautiful, beautiful story about how God can take something that seems so tiny and grow it into something that's great. And that's what God does, especially when we feel hopeless and insignificant. God says, even though you feel small, I will make something great of your life. Now, Jesus echoed that story in his story of how mustard seeds get planted and grow up into becoming mighty bushes. In the mustard plant where Jesus lived, these were called black mustard bushes, they grew maybe like 8 feet in 1 year. And the seeds that they came from are tiny. Many of you received those seeds earlier. You can see how small they are in your little vial, just tiny little things. But they can grow into becoming great bushes. And these mustard bushes take over whole gardens. They grow like crazy. So Jesus is making the point that God's goodness in our lives, like that tiny little seed, can start small, but it can grow into something great. So God is growing goodness within us that is grand. And God is growing something great because of the work that we do in the world around us. That's what we celebrate this morning. God is taking so many of us that seem small and doing great things through us. Think of our children. This is Children's Sunday. We've got lots of little ones here today. They're an important part of our church, of who we are. And they've started as tiny little things, and now they're sprouting, and maybe they're kind of like this, getting a little bit bigger. And they're able to lead us in worship. And someday we hope that they continue on and get their third grade Bibles and continue on and go through confirmation, like so many of our young people have done and are finishing today, to join our church as full members. We hope that they grow as members. We know a couple of our confirmands are going to be joining committees. We've got two of our young people who will be joining the music committee. And Bryce Bardell, who's a high school graduate, congratulations, Bryce, is going to be joining one of our boards as well. So this is great that we have young people who started out as tiny little sprigs and have grown in this congregation and are now among us and providing shade for others. This is a wonderful, wonderful thing that we celebrate. Now, it's also really cool to have a couple baptisms coming up here in the next few weeks for people who are children of those who started out as tiny little sprigs in this church. So we're going to be celebrating the baptisms of the children of Kayla and Kevin O'Neill and Juliana Fiore, who will be Doris Green's great-granddaughter, will be baptized here. So it's wonderful to see this cycle of how God can take the tiny little seeds and grow them up, and they grow and grow and grow and bring more life. This is something we celebrate this day, that we have life growing and flourishing among us in many, many kinds. I think one of the beautiful aspects of the readings that we heard earlier was that these things, when they grow, whether it's the great cedar tree or the great mustard bush, they provide shade and a place for birds to hang out and raise their young ones, to have their own home. And the birds mentioned in these scriptures are the birds of every kind. That's one thing that we celebrate here, is that we are a place where we can gather under the shade together, the shade of God's grace, and raise our young ones in it as birds of every kind. And we got some odd birds, and we got some strange birds, we got some big birds and little birds. We have birds of every kind here, and all are welcome. That is so beautiful, and that is our message that is unique and special. I think of so many of the other messages I hear around us that are very different from that message. And unfortunately, I know that there's going to be a gathering of one of our, another Protestant denomination that doesn't have such a welcoming stance, a gathering that's going to be happening this week, that you probably won't hear that same message. It's really a unique message that we say, all are welcome, no matter who you are, whom you love, or where you are on life's journey, you are welcome here, and you always will be. That is such a beautiful, beautiful message. There's room in the shade for all of God's creatures, all of us. So this day, I hope that that message can grow in your hearts. I hope that it can grow together as a community of faith, and I hope that we can bring this message to Stoneham, and to all the communities where we live, that that message might grow, that it might flourish, that it might become the way of all people, of all of our Christian sisters and brothers, of all people in this land. May we all become more loving and more welcoming. This is my prayer for all of us. And now I invite you to join with me in offering this prayer through song. We are going to sing our next hymn, "We Plant a Grain of Mustard Seed," which tells that story. It is our prayer together of how we hope to bring God's message of welcoming love to our community and to the whole world. Let us sing together, "We Plant a Grain of Mustard Seed." Delighted to be calling forward some of our young people for the rite of confirmation. And I invite you, as your name is called, to make your way towards the front here. You can just gather right along the building just beyond where Mr. Haddad is standing. Autumn Bardell. Oh, and there's some plants in the way, so please not trample them as you're heading that way. Autumn Bardell, Jake Bruno, Felicia Burgos, Meredith Corwin, and you can hold your applause to the end. There will be a big moment where we can jump in together. Caleb Sawicki, Avery Wall, and Gina Wierzbowski. And it was a privilege to be able to lead the class this year along with Kevin O'Neill. Oh, I'm sorry, Kai. How did I miss Kai? Come on up. My eyes are 2 years older than Christine's, so they don't work so well.
Trying to get yourself out of the doghouse there.
Yeah.
It's not working. It's not working.
All right. So, sisters and brothers in Jesus Christ, we are all received into the church through the sacrament of baptism. These young people gathered before us today have found nurture and support in the midst of the family of Christ. Through prayer and study, they have been led by the Holy Spirit to affirm their baptism and to claim in our presence the covenantal relationship with Christ as the members of this church. They are here for service to Christ, using the gifts which the Holy Spirit bestows. So, confirmants, We are now moving into the rite of confirmation.
The Apostle Paul writes, "You are no longer strangers and sojourners, but you are equally citizens with the saints and members of the household of God, built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, Christ Jesus along being the cornerstone, in whom the whole structure is joined together and grows into the holy temple of Christ, in whom you are built into for a dwelling place of God in the Spirit."
So, confirmants, I ask you some questions here. Do you desire to affirm your baptism into the faith and family of Jesus Christ? If so, please say, "I do." Do you profess Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior? If so, please answer, "I do." Do you promise by the grace of God to be Christ's disciple, to follow in the way of our Savior, to resist oppression and evil, to show love and justice, and to work and witness to the word of Jesus Christ as best you're able? If so, please answer, "I promise with the help of God." Do you promise, according to the grace given you, to grow in the Christian faith and to be a faithful member of the Church of Jesus Christ, celebrating Christ's presence and furthering Christ's mission in all the world? If so, please answer, "I promise with the help of God."
Let us affirm our faith together as we read a statement of faith from this year's class as led by Caleb Sawicki.
We are on a lifelong journey of faith, trusting in God, who is the maker of all that is. God created this good and beautiful world, filled it with creatures and people in all their varieties, and placed the sky with its beautiful sunsets and sunrises above it. God loves everything God has made, especially us. God accepts us and embraces all of us and supports us, calms us, brings us peace, and opens our minds through prayer. God has come to us in Jesus, a humble carpenter who became our selfless shepherd, our loving leader, and our mentoring teacher. Through Jesus Christ, God understands us and our flaws, shows us how to live in peace, and guides us to sacrifice for the good of others. God remains with us in all creation in the Holy Spirit, who is both an unstoppable force and gentle wind. Through the Spirit, we are enabled to sense God, to follow Christ's example, and to come together with others. God pulls us together as the church and calls us to continue God's acts of creating, building, healing, and helping. Together we share our talents and abilities with one another, and we care for the world, treating others as we would like to be treated, cherishing our breath and the breath of all of Earth's creatures, and leading others to live and love in God's creation.
Thank you, Caleb. Let us pray. Almighty God, who in baptism received these servants into the church, forgave their sins, and promised them eternal life, increase in them the gifts of your Holy Spirit. Grant love for others, joy in serving you, peace in disagreement, patience in suffering, kindness towards all people, goodness in evil times, faithfulness in temptation, gentleness in the face of opposition, and self-control in all things. Thereby strengthen them for their ministry in the world. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, we pray. Amen. So, confirmants, as I call your name, please step forward and bow your head to receive a prayer of blessing. Autumn Bardell. O God, in the grace of Jesus Christ, you have accepted this your servant, Autumn, through the water of baptism. Nourish in her the power of your Holy Spirit, that she may serve you forever in the world. Amen.
Jake Bruno. Jake, may the God of mercies multiply grace and peace in you, enable you truly and faithfully to keep your vows, defend you in every time of danger, preserve you to the end, and finally bring you to rest with all the saints in glory everlasting. Amen.
Amen. Felicia Burgos. Felicia, May the God of peace sanctify you. I pray that you will be preserved blameless to the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Meredith Corwin. Strengthen, O God, this your servant Meredith with your heavenly grace, that she may continue as yours forever and daily increase in her your Holy Spirit until you receive her at your last eternal home. Amen.
Kai Manny. Kai, may the God of mercies multiply grace and peace in you, enable you truly and faithfully to keep your vows, defend you in every time of danger, preserve you to the end, and finally bring you to rest with all the saints in glory everlasting. Amen.
Caleb Sawicki. O God, in the grace of Jesus Christ, you have accepted this, your servant Caleb, through the water of baptism. Nourish him in the power of your Holy Spirit, that he may serve you in the world. Amen. Amen.
Avery Wall. Avery, may the God of peace sanctify you. I pray that you will be preserved blameless to the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Gina Wierzbowski. Strengthen, O God, this your servant Gina with your heavenly grace, that she may continue as yours forever and daily increase in her your Holy Spirit until you receive her at your eternal home. Amen.
Amen. Let us pray together. We rejoice, O merciful God, with these people in the gift of the Holy Spirit and in the Spirit's power to awaken us to new truth and to inspire us to venture into fullness of life. We give you thanks that they have been moved to affirm their baptism. Help them to live not only for themselves, but for Christ and those whom Christ loves. Keep them steady and abounding in love, never giving up, pressing toward the goal of life with you and Jesus Christ. Amen.
By your baptism, you are made one with us in the body of Christ, the church. Today we rejoice in your pilgrimage of faith, which has brought you to this time and place. We celebrate your presence in this household of faith.
Confirmands, do you promise to participate in the life and mission of the First Congregational Church in Stoneham, owning its covenant, sharing regularly in the worship of God, and enlisting in the work of this particular gathering of God's people as it serves this community and the world? If so, please answer, I promise with the help of God.
Let us, the members and friends of the First Congregational Church of Stoneham, express our welcome and affirm our mutual ministry in Christ. Will those who served as mentors to these students please stand? Thank you for your service to these young people, to God, and to the church. I invite all members and friends of the church who are comfortable doing so to please stand.
To those of you who are members of the First Congregational Church in Stoneham, having witnessed these confirmands' expressions of commitment to Christ and this particular household of faith, welcome them as fellow members of the church. If so, please say, we do.
We do.
We do.
Members and friends of the church, will you offer them your ongoing love, support, and care? If so, please say, we promise our love, support, and care.
We promise our love, support, and care.
Thank you. Please be seated. We pray once more. Almighty and ever-living God, may your hand be ever over your servants who have confirmed their baptism this day. May your Holy Spirit ever be with them. So lead them in the knowledge and obedience of your word, that they may serve you in this life and dwell with you in the life to come. Amen.
At the beginning of our program, you received a new Bible as a gift from the church. After the service, each of you will also receive certificates of confirmation along with a prayer shawl that was lovingly knitted by a member of our congregation to remind you, whenever you wear it, the love of the people of this church will always surround you.
And now, in the name of Jesus Christ and on behalf of the First Church, we extend to you the right elbow of Christian love and fellowship as those who have confirmed their baptism and own the covenant of our church. Welcome and congratulations. Crowd goes wild. This is wonderful. It's a wonderful celebration of life. And we do share a life together as a family of faith. There are concerns that we have as a family that we bring to one another to lift up to God together in prayer. And we'd like for you to be keeping in prayer. Kim Savage, as she recovers from surgery, for Dick's friend Carol, diagnosed with Alzheimer's, for Marie B., who is recovering from hip surgery. Also, we ask for you to be keeping in prayer Hannah K., as she is going to be undergoing back surgery on Friday. Also, please keep in your prayers the family of Bridget Sheehan Pond, as her sister and brother-in-law lost their baby girl, Quinn, who was stillborn this week. Also, please keep in prayer Dave's friend, Chris, whose 19-year-old daughter was killed in a car collision this week as well. And does anybody else have a word of concern or a joy that they would like to bring to the congregation for prayer? Yes. So Sue's niece, Sarah, is doing well. We've been praying for her ribs, and they are healing up. And Kevin.
For the family of Chuck Carroll, he passed away last night after a two-month battle with cancer. Just a friend of mine from
Okay. So prayers for Kevin's friend, Chuck, and Chuck's family, who passed away this week from cancer. Dick. Absolutely. This is something to celebrate. Yes, we gather together and we give God thanks. Let us come to God in prayer. Loving Creator, we gather as one community of faith and as part of one global family to worship you. We pray for our church and those throughout the world who follow Christ. May we all be one. May each of us truly and humbly serve you, that your realm of love would grow and flourish among all the people of the earth. Give us seeds of grace to grow in our own hearts, that we may produce fruits of doing your good will in all that we undertake. We pray this also for all who govern and all who hold authority in the nations of the world, that they may come to do your work of enacting justice and making peace on earth. O God, this Pride Month, we pray especially for the leaders of this land on every level to be inspired to treat all the people who live here, no matter who they are, whom they love, or how they wish to be understood, with equal dignity and respect. May those of our leaders whose hearts are made cold or closed by fear or hate come to have their hearts warmed and their minds opened. We pray for those in our religious communities who preach love but do not live it, to discover the joyous freedom that comes through loving and welcoming people just as they are, just as our teacher Jesus did. Bless all among us who have felt unwelcomed because of who they are. And may we be a community where your law of love reigns over us. And may our love for each other inspire all around us to be more loving as well. O God of love, on this special day in which we celebrate that our church community is diverse in many ways, help us to become more united. On this Children's and Confirmation Sunday, may those of us who are children and youth feel just as welcomed and valued in this family's faith as those of us who were children many years ago. May our family be one where the old are inspired by the joy and enthusiasm of the young, and the young grow as their elders share their wisdom and love. We pray, O God, for the old and the young alike, who are struggling today with the health in their bodies or minds. Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble, that they may be delivered from their distress. And we pray especially for Bridget's family and for Dave's coworker, Chris, that they may find comfort in knowing that your light ever shines upon their loved ones. O God, you have made us from the dust of the same earth, and you've sent your blessed Son to preach peace to those who are far off from you and those who are near to you. Grant that people everywhere may seek after you and find you. Bring the nations into your fold. Pour out your Spirit on all flesh and hasten the coming of your kingdom. We pray all this through Jesus Christ, our Savior, who unites us and who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Donna Wall to come forward for the presentation of our scholarships and camperships.
So this is a real honor for me this year. Usually Lorraine gets to do this. This is just a real pleasure for me to be able to acknowledge our graduates this year on so many different levels. This has really close meaning to me. So I would like to honor our graduates from last year. Now, before I say any names, I just want to say that we asked on numerous levels who our graduates were this year and who our graduates were last year, because we didn't get to do this last year. So if we miss someone, I'm sorry. You can come yell at me at the end of service. But this is the list that was given to us in the office. So I would now like to acknowledge this last year's and this year's graduates. So Nick Bruno. That's all right. We'll make sure you get it home to him. Autumn Bardell. I won't bite. Good job. Hugs are free. You just have to ask. Hannah Corwin. Congratulations. Those are our graduates from last year. So just know that they've gone on ahead with their future plans, and we are just as excited about it. This year's graduates, we have Bryce Bardell.
When do some of these kids get this tall? Congratulations. Felicia? You want a hug?
You're welcome.
Kira Manny? This one's mine. Meredith Bilbo. Meredith. Oh, right, her. I'm looking at Meredith Corwin going, why isn't she getting up? Sorry. Brain squeeze. And Tessa Storm. So these are some of our other graduates. Thank you to all of you. Congratulations to all of you. I hope that your futures are just blessing wishes that just fly with you every day, no matter where you are. So the other little thing that CE handles are camperships and scholarships, and these take the time of filling out a form and asking questions and, you know, just a little due diligence to this. So I'd like to honor those that have taken the time to ask for a little help on their summer retreat or their college endeavors. So we have a campership for Hudson Little. I don't see them here. Nope, we'll make sure he gets it. Hannah Corwin. Congratulations. Autumn Bardell, can you do it one more time, Autumn? There's a hug at the end.
Another one? Yeah. There you go, good girl.
Bryce Bardell, not all things are easy in life. This is hard. Congratulations. And Felicia. There you go, love.
You're welcome.
Congratulations to all.
And also, Donna, I think you were going to say a word of special word.
Oh, see?
Oh, wait, Heidi, don't go anywhere.
See, I didn't have a script in front of me, and that's part of my problem. Okay, so someplace in the crowd, yep, I have two little gifts over there, and if I can join Miss Heidi up here, please. Thank you. So come on up here. So these special gifts can give Miss Heidi her flowers. I don't want the flowers there for Miss Heidi. Can you give those to Miss Heidi in her little bag? Yeah, they're really interested in what's in the bag. Say thank you. So Miss Heidi, who is our Sunday school superintendent, in order for us to make our budget this year, gave up her paycheck and has worked her buns off this year to make sure just about every Sunday, I think you've only missed three this year, every Sunday she has done Sunday school online with the kids. And any of the kids who've done online Miss Heidi, they have done some like really awesome stuff. So this is a thank you from CE, and this is a thank you from the church. Enjoy, you're our angel.
I was gonna say this at the end, but I just wanna say, what a privilege it is for me that you guys trust me with your kids every Sunday. And I take it really seriously. And seeing these kids up here getting confirmed today is like my own kids getting confirmed. So I'm just so proud of them, all of them. Thank you.
Thank you, Heidi. And it is based on trust. We trust each other. We bring our resources in the form of our children, in the form of our work of our hands, in the form of our financial resources. And we do all this because we know that when we bring these, they're like seeds that God can raise up to become mighty cedars. And so we recognize at this time the gifts that we bring to God in our pledges. This is Stewardship Sunday, and in this year, which was unlike any other, we were fortunate to have a stewardship campaign led by Tim Corwin and our stewardship team. Thank you all for your good work. And I'm just going to say on their behalf that it's not too late. If you didn't get your pledge card in, we have extras. We've got some here. So if you have your pledge card, normally we'd have you come forward in the service and bring it forward. We won't do that today. But on your way out this morning, you can drop your pledge card in the offering plate if you haven't already sent it in. And
right over here.
And if you're inspired to write a pledge, if you haven't yet done so, we've got extras, so you can leave your pledge card in the offering plate. It is truly an act of trust, saying that you will entrust the church with your resources so that we could work together to build up Christ Church into something beautiful in the world. So thank you for those of you who have pledged, and thanks to those of you who will pledge for all of your good work to make our church a beautiful place for people of all ages. And now, quickly, we move on to our offering time. God remembers our offerings of genuine... Excuse me. I'm going to invite T.J. Corwin to come and lead us in our offering time. I've already talked way too much.
God remembers our offerings of genuine thankfulness in regards with the favor of sacrifices we make to extend God's realm. We give not because we have to, but freely and with joy. Whatever our ages or ability, we have something to give. Let us give thanks as we present our offerings.
All to Jesus I surrender, all to Him I freely give. I will ever love and trust Him in His presence day.
Surrender.
please join me in the unison prayer of dedication. All that we have is yours, O God. We may present what the church uses no sacrifice. We are happy to share good news in your word and deed. May our work together grow by the time and talents and treasure we give. We would no longer live just for ourselves, but for the seeing of your reign among us. Let all things become new as we give our best. Amen.
And for the sake of time, we will sing just the first and fourth verse of Joyful, Joyful, We Adore Thee. Mustard seed faith with the world. God will make of it more than you can imagine.
We will dare to speak of God's love. We will seek to live out the love of Christ.
In Christ we are a new creation. Our dried up faith has received new life.
The mighty have been toppled from power. The humble and lowly have been lifted up.
Walk by faith, not by sight. God will add to your understanding day by day.
We will seek to view others as God sees them. We will claim them as sisters and brothers.
And now, as our service here comes to an end, your service to the world outside continues. And as you go, may God's grace and peace be with you this day and every day. Amen. And I ask for you to be seated just for another minute. We have a very special closing today, led by Heidi.
As everybody knows, this year was a year like no other, especially for Sunday school. But we found a way to really enjoy our lessons over Zoom Sunday. On Zoom Sundays, we watched movies, we did our Bible lessons. But one of the things that we really enjoyed, and we did no fail every Sunday, was a Bible scavenger hunt. So I would read a Bible verse, and then the kids would have to go running off and find the item that was related to that Bible verse, and then bring them back so that we could share that fun with each other. So, since this is the last official day of Sunday school, we wanted to share that with all of you. And we are going to do an all-church scavenger hunt. We're gonna start with every reading the rules.
Everyone must sit still and work together to figure out what item we must find. Do not go find the object until we agree and the countdown is complete.
Okay, so we're going to read the Bible verse. Everybody sit still and we will work together to figure out what we are finding.
So he called 10 of his servants and gave them 10 coins. Put this money to work, he said, until I come back.
Can anybody figure out what the item is we must go find? Coins. There are about 200 gold and silver chocolate coins hidden around these grounds right now. Some of them may have already been found, but that's okay. Everybody's going to wait for the countdown, and then you may get up, enjoy the rest of your day, and search for the coins.
3, 2, 1. Everybody go find the coins.
Yeah, it would be weird to do it now.
No, that's correct.